We have Dr. Shantanu Sen. Yes.
Supposed to speak on both the bills together?
You have 6 minutes, yes. Both together.
Thank you, madam. Madam, it's really good to see you on the chair.
Thank you.
Sir, I must start with, in the history I have seen, there was only one Dhritarashtra and one Gandhari who were sufficient enough to ruin the Gurukul. But nowadays you are seeing everywhere this government, which is absolutely of undemocracy by privatization and for spoiling the entire health system by ruining the ancient systems of medicine. Everywhere they are putting 7 Gandharis. I must not say that our Honorable Health Minister, who belongs to our own profession, is the Dhritarashtra. But I am sure that Dhritarashtra is sitting somewhere else and giving the signal to ruin the entire health of the country. Madam, I think I am a fool, because till date I am expecting something good from this government, the leaders of which they say that you don't need to take any medicine to fight COVID. Bhabiji's purport will give you the cure, and cow's urine will be the remedy for COVID. What more can be expected from this type of government, madam? Madam, this government is in a mood to ruin all the ancient systems of medicine and to promote quackery, which is obvious even by the National Education Policy 2020, where it is clearly mentioned that after 2030, there will be no existence of any individual system of medicine in the country, which Indian Medical Association has been opposing since beginning, madam. Madam, so far the homeopathy issue is concerned, I must let you know, everywhere this government is in a mood to dissolve the elected body. In the Homeopathy Council, it was an elected body which was running the system very smoothly. They formed nearly 285 colleges. But unfortunately, when they were running democratically, they were having 50 representatives from different parts of the country, from different states. They simply dissolved this elected body and they formed a board of governors of 7 members, 7 Gandharis, madam. Indian homeopathy system is very much popular in West Bengal. Not a single representative of West Bengal, madam. But unfortunately, since this board of governors were formed, initially it was for 1 year, 2018 for 2019. They miserably failed to function. They did not inspect the medical colleges. They couldn't provide adequate number of teachers. Again, they asked for extension from 2019 to 2020. And then now, again, indirectly by admitting their failure once again, they are asking for extension for another 1 year, madam. No election in the recent past, no transparency. They could not make any further progress, madam. See, if you come to our West Bengal, you will see there is a National Institute of Homeopathy. So miserable condition it is, it's just unbelievable, madam. They are not having teachers. They are running pediatric course without having specialist doctors. On the contrary, they are saying in this new proposed bill, they are saying that for giving appointment in a post of lecturer, they must be a postgraduate one. I must let you know, there are many disciplines in homeopathy, like anatomy, gynae, pathology, community medicine, surgery, FMT, etc. But there is no specialization. So how they are going to appointment lecturers in this system? This is my question, madam.
Doctor, madam, only 2 minutes left, so please start.
Yes, madam,
concluding.
Now they are indirectly promoting quackery. They are telling those who are having an experience of practicing homeopathy for last 5 years, they will be getting registers. Now, if I come to the, and indirectly they are promoting private medical colleges here and there. There is mushrooming of private medical colleges, especially if you go to the state of Gujarat, you will see. Now, if I come to the IMCC ordinance, madam, National Medical Commission, it has been formed, gadget notification has been done, but it is not functioning. What is the use of Indian Medical Council once the National Medical Commission has been formed? I am a member of National Medical Commission from West Bengal, but since the formation of National Medical Commission, I was never called in a meeting. No meeting took place. Only a chairman is sitting in there on the chair from AIIMS. He is doing good for nothing. He is doing nothing. Once again, they are asking for the extension of this board of governors. Again, the 7 Gandharis, madam. Madam, I must let you know.
Honourable member, only 1 minute left. Please start concluding.
It is absolutely a betrayal to the parliament. This board of governors They are simply the parasite on the public exchequer, madam. They are enjoying their power. They are doing nothing. Once the National Medical Commission has been formed, I think there is no use of extension of this Board of Governors, because practically they are doing nothing. No extension, no, it's not at all needed, madam. And this Board of Governors, they are not functioning. My humble submission before our Honorable Health Minister, we need to know, we have the right to know, why NMC, after getting gazette notification, has not yet been implemented properly. And my final submission will be before this Dhritarashtra, who is sitting somewhere else and sending his instruction to the Gandharis through our Honorable Health Minister. Please count on politics, no problem. Play religious card as you do, no problem. Feet pick up during the pandemic, no problem.
Thank you.
Please,
thank you, Doctor.
Do not play with the health of the country. Please do not play with the health of the country. Please do not play with the health of the country.
Thank you, Honorable Member. Now it is Sri Prasanna Acharya Ji.